645 plus 102,971. $431,308.
How much?
$431,308.
We're gonna get that off 17.
Oh, I bet we get 5 or 6 trucks off 17. That is a huge field.
We're at 4 and 3 on nutrients. 3 and 3 years.
Yeah, that's what 6 and 7 were.
I went and sprayed it twice, I think. I just did course 1 again.
Oh yeah.
Are we gonna do yeah, I moved it over. Are we gonna do a whole perimeter pass, or are we gonna kinda do this in sections?
We can do it in sections if you want. It might be easier.
Yeah.
Count like 20 or count like 10 or 12. Well, depends on how far you want to go. Cut it in half.
Maybe like a third.
Sure, that'll work for me.
And then cut that in half.
Yeah.
And do our like, so Mike's always in the middle.
Well, we could do that, or we could cut a square, cut a section out of the middle and just make one of the squares smaller and then go to the other one. It's just whatever you do. Kind of like how we did one small jump on the north side of the left corner. Just kept going around the one side, making it smaller. It really don't matter to me. Whatever Mike's happy with. Mike's the one that's got to deal with it. Yeah. Spend 2 months tilling, spraying, and planting for like a week's worth of harvest.
It's a lot of work to balance out the pH and all the nutrients, you know.
Yeah.
I should have sprayed. I should have hit this again with like NPK.
Or you just gotta do the Raphael. 47N.
Yeah. I'm good for 5 seasons, guys. That's not how it works.
Raphael, how much crap did you spread? A lot. You ever seen that Vic Lake? He was on the Southeast farm on Wednesday and he took a photo. He had like 47 for an end radius. It's like Joe goes, how much did you spread? A lot.
Mike, you wanna come get me?
I think he's dumping trucks. He's moving trucks. I'll just take that pass you were gonna do, and that way you can dump. Yeah, I think cutting a big deal better portion helps.
cruise control works backwards now?
You didn't know?
Yeah. It screws you big time.
I did not. That must be the new one I installed, because it wasn't in the old one. That's sweet.
Hey, Mike, I dare you to try that video that was going around Facebook and Instagram of the cart driving backwards underneath the combine while it was unloading.
Have you seen that? What is it? Is it that one? What tractors is it?
It's a 9R on a 1300 Kinsey going backwards, unloading across the field.
I've seen one, I think, I don't think it was an RT doing the same thing.
Yeah, the one I've seen is there's a custom crew out of Bowdell, South Dakota that they did the video. That was pretty funny. Did we miss as much planting or what? Because I've got a whole row here.
That's the tire and the sprayer.
Oh, you must have been between the rows with the other tire.
Yeah, sometimes it takes out juice, sometimes there's only one. It really depends on where you are, I guess.
120 foot might help us a little bit more, because then that's one less. Well, that's 30 extra feet you get per pass.
So we're at 4 and 3. So we're pretty well under ideal nutrients, but...
Can you make it to the other end, or is Mike going to have to come get you?
I'm at 97, so...
I'm going to wait for you to get to the end here, Jake. But it takes me too long to get around.
Yeah, Joe can just wait.
Cut him a little headland.
Well, I figured, yeah, I'd go up here. Or just pull a course plane drive right through the center of the field.
I do like how this looks now with the taller corn stalks to get knocked down from the tires.
Yeah, you should probably do that with your wheat stubble, because sometimes wheat stubble don't go all the way down. Depends on what they're cutting it with.
Yeah.
I know a lot of guys that just cut the heads off the top of the wheat with a reel head.
Well, we're dropping that draper all the way to the bottom, you know, so.
Yeah.
Because we have it set up for beans. It's not like you're going to.
Let her skid on the floor.
That blue on blue does look pretty sharp, though.
Yeah, but could you imagine blue on green?
Yeah.
Did you ever remake a 9560 RT like you did that 7R? That 7R green is pretty good.
What are you saying?
Fuck it, I'm just gonna guess the center.
You can eyeball it on your little PDA map, you know?
Yeah.
That Kinsey isn't even dirty yet.
Mine's
getting
dirty.
A little dusty.
Have yet to get that thing dusty in game.
What's that?
The Kinsey.
I was using the old one, then when I put this one in game, because the old one was dirty, it automatically showed up dirty in my game.
I don't know if it's a hindrance if we would have two of these big bin ones or just one big one.
Well, I think it gives the cart driver a lot more time.
Yeah.
To have the bigger bin. You know, because you have two of my bins in there basically, so if you're at like 50-60%, you know, that's like unloading a full bin of meat.
So I wonder if we made the tire tracks on that sprayer just a little bit narrower, if we actually tried, I wonder if we could run between the rows and not wreck anything.
I don't I don't think so, because I think the number block system's so weird on this game that you can't actually... You know, if that was true, then these headers would be taking,
yeah,
you know, this corn in perfectly every time, but it's just... Maybe if you had, like, a regular 1X map, but every time you go into a 4X, everything just gets a little bit less...
Yeah.
Perfect.
Imagine that 16X getting built on AEM.
I think it would be fun, but I mean, even on this map, we're only doing about a third of the land, you know?
Why did that East River, West River, Salem map in 13, and there's no way you could do 16X without having, like, 8 people on the server constantly.
But the thing is, like...
It's out for 50.
Oh, I think it, one Salem is, I know.
But, like, what's the point? I mean, you make so much money that, like, what do you spend it on?
I'll do like what we used to. If you get a certain number of hours on the thing, you have to trade it in.
Yeah.
One thing I like, the new one, whatever, he's got another farmer, so there's an actual tractor out always seeding in this one field, so it looks like there's somebody else farming the map too.
Yeah, that'd be nice.
I think what they should really adopt in Farm Sim is like an MMO kind of thing. You know,
yeah,
where it's like a real world environment and you actually own land and you could buy, sell land, sell
you
equipment.
What kind of computer you would need to run that though?
No, I mean, it's the same. Look at like Diablo. It's like the same thing as Diablo
Destiny.
Yeah, it's like the same concept. And then like, you think about it, like people that want a mod, they can like submit their mod to Giants or whoever, whatever company it is. And, you know, they would get, like, money for it, and then people would use it, and it would just be standard in the game. I think that would be, like, I think that would be highly successful.
Oh, yeah. Then I get away with a lot of people hack editing and stuff. No, Mike should be full.
And it, like, really would open up the whole, like, it would make it an actual community, like, a living, and there's no, there's a great demand shit. Like, the economy would fluctuate by based on what people are farming and buying,
yeah,
and selling. And
it'd be nice if somebody made it like at the elevator, like you can haul grain to your elevator, put it on delayed price,
yeah,
and it costs you so many cents per bushel to do it.
Contract it.
Yep. Because there's times that we charge for DP, and then there's times the company I work for, we need the corn, we'll give you free DP for this many months.
Yeah.
We even have farmers that have condo storage in our elevator, so it don't even cost them. They bought the space in our elevator. Well, I could probably turn my hazards off.
Yeah, I mean, if you don't want to build your own bins, it'd probably be cheaper to buy existing space, you know? Especially if... That would give the elevator, like, a constant supply. Like, they wouldn't have to, you know, that's guaranteed to be filled, so...
Not really. It don't have to be. They don't ever completely fill their condo storage. The guy that has condo storage, he's also got bin space at his farm.
Yeah. Would it be cheaper for him to dry his grain there or at his place?
Probably cheaper for him to dry it at his place. They dock, what is it? 2% for every point of moisture. So we take it, we don't, once you get over, I think once you hit the 16 mark, we have to dry it and we charge you. So if you hit like a 17, you take a 2% bushel dockage. So your 1,000 bushel load just probably turned into like a 980 or a 975. And then if you got really.
What do you start at? 12%?
14%? No, 14 to 16. If it's over 16, you gotta dry it, otherwise it'll...
What's that, corn?
Yeah. Yeah.
What do they do beans at?
Beans are below 12.
I think Mike's having fun in that cart now.
It's
coming in. That's hot, Leadfoot.
Well, I think it's nice now that he's got 50-some thousand of space. You don't have 33 like that 1050 did.
Yeah. I think I'm going to make a 1300 bushel.
Just upsize the 1100 just a little bit more.
You know, I had to take a lot off the 1500 to make the 1100. So what I think I'm going to do is make a 1300 from the... It's just a little bit shorter than the 1500, the 13, the back end.
Mm-hmm.
And then I was looking at to make a wheel, but I had to really redo the whole body.
Yeah, you'd have to indent the inside.
The way I have it set up is I did like a bowl-in feature, and it, like, I really can't edit it. It really messes up the whole body if I try to like turn it into a wheel. So
if you had big old floor tires on the 1100, it'd be kind of nice.
Yeah,
or
I mean,
roll crops don't really matter.
And then I had to like make a new frame to it, so there's quite a bit of, you know, new
work.
Mapping and texturing just to make the wheel version
Screw
of it.
Tracks look nice.
I mean, there's a lot of other things I'd rather like spend my time.
I'll just catch you on the other side, Mike.
Oh, I'll follow me then.
I moved to 11 miles an hour.
Ideally, we should have another guy like doing tillage right
or
behind
running,
us.
Or running truck constantly.
Yeah. I mean, we could fill up a truck with a full cart now, so it's pretty efficient operation. Just about where we want to be. If we were running 16 row headers, I would be stopping all the time. I think Jake would be pretty good, but yeah, I haven't really used those Lexion combines yet. I use it for like an hour one night.
They're nice. I used them maybe one night. They handle nice. They're pretty good looking too.
I did quite a bit of work on them. I used Raphael's old 1770 texture, not the one that came with it from 13. So it has a little bit different skin on it than everyone else. Tweaked some suspension settings on it. I just don't like the i3D file on it. It's so messy inside, you know? But
for what? Your planner?
No, the Lexion combine.
Oh.
You know, if you ever open them up in GE, it's just like a total, you know.
Is it as bad as that John Deere air drill? That i3D has been a mess for how many?
I mean, all those Lego built, they all get hacked up, and they, you know, they're all Band-Aid jobs.
Because, yeah, they took the John Deere, made it into the Borgo drill.
Yeah.
When I was editing all that, trying to make it flex and change it around, holy shit, trying to figure out that mess was...
Well, you remember when we first put that drill in the game and how the flex was till Joe messed with it?
Oh yeah, you'd hit a little bump and the outer wing would pop all the way up in the air.
Oh really? I never messed around with it. Jake just said to fix it, so I fixed it how I had everything else set up, and it works good.
I think I sent you a picture because it literally looked like a V when you'd hit a bump with one part. It just, both pieces would go straight up. It's like it's binding.
Yeah, I had the Borgo drill set up in 13 pretty well as a flex.
Yeah, the one piece Borgo for 15. It's like, who makes it one piece?
I was using that on this map for a while just because I needed a big air suit and there's nothing available.
Well, we used that for quite a while.
I didn't really feel like doing, you know, for whatever reason, like... Big air seeders don't really appeal to me. I'd rather like do the 30-inch space planters, but don't know, I was kind of that Porsche Anderson, they came out with a big ass, like 1,000 bushel track seed cart, 64 foot. And I'm like, I really want to make this. It's not that complex of a model, you know? It's nice, clean, and sleek. And
just huge.
Huge.
And it's built ridiculous. Like, I've looked at one of those in person. They're built so heavy duty, it's ridiculous. Like, the size of the frame and tires on the whole thing is...
It's built for... You're never going to have to touch it.
Yeah. It's built, honestly, it's like, the frame-wise on the drill, it's built like a more built. Heavy duty, you know, simple. I like the tank a lot. The track tank with the conveyor augers.
Yeah, it has the TerraTrax from Kloss on it. So.
Yeah.
You know what's nice about the air seater with that though is if you can script the auger, and then we can script like the trailer to hold the seat. So like, because we got guys at our elevator that will come in with their semi trailer and go fill it with seat, and we fill it with bean seat.
Yeah. Well, that's. I had the Borgo tank. I had the auger off the John Deere, gripped it to swing around and fill three tanks on the Borgo.
You know, whoever did the John Deere seater for 11, I don't know if you can think back that far, but you remember where they. Well, yeah, because it had. You could fill the back, and you could fill the back with two compartments. Like the back compartment of the seater could be filled with fertilizer or seed. The front could be filled with fertilizer or seed, but not both of them would fill at the same time.
Yeah, that was that, was it King's?
Next head, yeah. That thing was epic. You know, I loved the crap.
Well, it was the same thing at 13.
No, it didn't fill like it did in 11.
I did it for MR, and I had to have Darrell help me update the LUA file. So.
Yeah, because in the one I had for 13 didn't do that.
Well, the 13, like, I took that script and I put it on the Borgo tank, and I could do the same thing. I could fill either tank with fertilizer or seed.
Yep. And then it pump it out through the front of the seed.
Yeah.
And you wouldn't have that stupid skip, like, if you turned.
Yeah. That was my issue, though, is I wanted to turn. I couldn't turn that script to run a tow behind tank instead of the tow between like it was. And that's the only I couldn't figure that out for.
Yeah. Because 11, it was a tow behind script.
Oh, okay. So, yeah, 13, they turned it into a tow between. And I couldn't, like, I could get the tank and everything to turn on, but I couldn't get the openers to drop to actually initiate the seeding.
Yeah, you had almost skipped it so that it seeded like 10 meters in front of it.
Drove me fucking bananas. I spent 2 months trying to figure that out. Even the master Albert on EEM couldn't tell me how to do it.
That guy's both useless.
You better go talk to like a monkey. You have a better chance of that.
You can't get the engine script in 15. Bullshit, my Peterbilt has it.
That West, was it West Morgan?
West Morgan built, knows what he's doing.
They built a really nice cedar 13, the case. Case drill with the full wing flex and folded out properly with the hitch and everything.
Yeah, that Alan Galindio or whatever that Raphael knows, that dude made a pretty decent one for 15.
Yeah, I saw that.
Yeah, well, you open it up and it's a total, it's like, I don't know. It doesn't look like, it looks like it was pieced together, you know? Because it's like 30 textures on that thing. It's crazy.
I think he used the drill off the existing one, didn't he, and just made a new tank?
I think so, yeah.
I like that new tank that he built, that new case. The cart.
Yeah, that called the whole, everybody's going to that PVC or like, you know, like a
the poly
plastic tank now, so they can run, they have the option to run liquid.
Yeah. Corrosion resistant.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's another thing. Jake, how often do you have to replace your hoses and nozzles? I mean, you're running pretty dilute, or are you running concentrate through
for
your
what?
Sprayers?
Oh, I don't think I've, honestly, on my Patriot, I've run it for 3 years, and I don't even think about it. some stuff's pretty thick.
Do you clean that out with water after you're done spraying, or?
Well, you have to if you switch crops, because
yeah.
some stuff for beans, well, okay, the stuff to kill broad leaves and corn, like a bunch of your weeds and corn, will murder beans. And then there's some stuff you take to get the volunteer corn out of your beans that, well, take volunteer corn out of your beans and spray it on your cornfield.
Yeah, I'm saying, like, at the end of the day, do you flush your lines or do you just leave it?
Oh, yeah, I flush my lines every day, or, and then I have to rinse it out when I go, and rinse it out is a pain in the butt.
Yeah.
Jake, you're not going to make it down there, are you?
You're 86 and I would not go across.
Whatever, I'm going to 90 and I'll just go over and shave the part off the road over here like I do in real life. Done that in real life, you know, not about halfway across the field. And screw it, went back up about 13 and turned it to the other road.
I'll do this. Turn around. Then the next road, just go all the way down and come back.
Here's how we do it in South Dakota.
Do you want me on the left or right, Jake?
Nah, go on the left, kind of like how I did to you.
I'm going to have to take a break here pretty quick. I'm starving. You grab something.
I'm just going to keep going here, and when Joe hits the spot, he can go over and finish that rope. How we do it in real life. You come up here, empty me, and I take off in this row, and Joe's got to finish the other row. We've done it. Both combines going across the same, like, what we're doing now.
Yeah.
Well, one got full, so I backed up, and he stopped, and I just cut across. Well, I backed up enough when he got close to me, he jumped into my lane, and I backed up and started taking his lane and started dumping so we could keep going.
Okay.
Makes sense. I mean, if you're running long rows until you can get a cart lane.
Well, if you have 200 bushel corn with a normal hopper, you're barely going to make it across a quarter mile field before you're full.
Yeah, unless you drop header size. You know?
Yeah. 12 roll, barely make it across a quarter mile field. Well, yeah. Mile-long rounds. It gets entertaining. The two carts are flying. No, other side, Joe.
Other side?
Good thing I was twirling my camera. Joe's... The only good thing about that small combine is you can unload faster and get going.
Yeah.
Well, I unload the same.
Yeah, I know, but when I have a full tank, it takes me twice the time to unload to get going again.
But you can still go, you know.
Joe will be about full.
I'm at 50.
All right, screw it. Just take off. You might have to come forward a little bit and back up, because I don't know if I got everything across the middle there. How many trucks do we think we're going to get? Four? Five?
Well, we're going to have two full ones already.
Yeah, well, you're going eating. Me and Joe can probably take a dump of those.
He's got about another truck almost in his...
Oh, shit.
I don't know if we need another truck, unless we have somebody else that's going to be on full-time.
Yeah,
just easier to rent one when we have a great demand.
We're going to be doing that to get to the end.
How full are you? 80? Oh, yeah.
I realize, Jake, that the tarp's on the wrong side on this Kinsey.
Why?
Remember you told me that on the old one, right?
Yeah, but, well, no. That's
aren't they usually away from the combine, though?
Yeah, they're away from the combine.
Oh, okay. So it was the other one that was...
It's your semizer. No, yeah, your semizer on the wrong side.
Oh, Raphael's?
Yeah, the Wilson, they're on the wrong side. You know those Brazilians that do everything backwards. Yeah, the semis are on the wrong side. Cranky. Tarp on the other side.
We should have planted more corn.
Should have. Turned out pretty good.
Well, the corn's gonna fill up our silos. We get better price on beans, don't we? We get more money in beans per acre than we do if we go more acre of corn. It really depends on our yield, though, right? If we get good corn yields, we do pretty good.
Oh, yeah.
If we get...
There's two full trucks.
You just want to stop here while you go to the dump road. I do like the match. Do we want to put the trucks in the field from now on?
Just set them back so they don't get in the way of you guys turning.
Two tip triggers.
Mm-hmm.
But I definitely need to build a new fill plane for these things. This thing's old.
No.
And it looks like it glitches, you know?
Why? Oh, gotta write that down. No.
So these are two more 54.
Yeah.
673.
109,346.
I only have 52,929 miles on my truck.
Don't tell me what my mileage is. Probably the same as yours. You check to see how full your bin is. Does it tell you, or did you not put that piece in there?
It's that last bin right before you pull out on the road.
Oh, I didn't even look. I was trying to avoid the mailbox.
And then we have these three smaller. I scripted them as 10,000 bushels.
Hey, don't we have the bins up there too at the old farm on the north of 44 too? Isn't there two bins there?
Yeah.
So we actually technically, those are the two bins you're talking about.
We're at 545,875. But we don't have that much corn left.
No.
And we have up at that farm on the hill, we have those bins. Then we have the bins by the house.
mean, we could still pull out of other bins, but at least it's, hey, it's nice that it's got a total fill volume.
Yeah, it's not perfect, but it's a lot better than infinite.
Yeah, you can't shove the whole map into one bin site.
Yeah.
Too bad you can't script the weeds to sometimes like slow your combine down. Because if you hit a bunch of that grass with a cornet, it's really gonna slow your combine down. You get some ragweed into that combine, you'll just hear it go.
Do you guys have a lot of milkweed out in the Dakotas?
Not really any, not that we've seen. We don't have too much milkweed. We have a lot of, like,
are those Hefty Brothers over by you?
What?
The Hefty Brothers?
Yeah, they live like 15 miles north of me.
Do they own that they're... Because on their videos they say they do 2,700 crop acres, or do they lease a lot of that?
I think they own that.
If you look in your plat book, you'd be able to see who owns what.
Yeah, I don't have plat candy. But I do know they own Hefty Seed Company. They own a couple seed companies and a couple agronomy places around the state.
What do they do, soil tests?
I think so. Well, there's a lot of people that actually started their own business doing soil testing. All you need is a four-wheeler and a crow.
So what do they make their own seeds, or are they just a distributor?
They have it through the government that they can make their own seed. Basically, if you get a grant from a government to sell seed, you can use seed beans that you harvest, put them in your bin, and then sell them.
So you, like, you wash your own seeds, basically, like how they used to do it?
Yeah. Before it became illegal.
Before Monsanto lobbied that shit?
Yeah.
It's actually illegal now?
Yeah, oh yeah, it's frowned upon. If you get caught doing it, you're in a lot of trouble.
Why is that?
Because it's Monsanto.
That's how it always used to be. You'd always save your best seed, right?
Yeah, not lately.
But that's just on soybean, right?
Yeah.
What's that Liberty?
Liberty? Liberty is just a different form of corn, basically. Liberty Link is just a different version of Roundup Ready. Because people wanted to get away from Roundup, because Roundup's becoming... Weeds are becoming resistant to Roundup after 30 years. So Liberty Link is a different chemical variation compared to Roundup.
Yeah.
It's the same thing as Roundup Ready corn, it's just different chemical variation. You spray Roundup on Liberty Link corn, you're going to kill the corn.
Yeah.
As if you spray Liberty Link on Roundup Ready. 91, I should make it to the other side.
You remember when I first started putting ATIs on the combine shake, how shitty those things turn?
Yeah. When we first did it on the New Holland?
And I finally figured out how to make it turn decent.
Yeah, because what was it, the first time you stuck them on the New Holland, it didn't want to...
It slid.
It didn't want to follow GPS very well. Like,
yeah.
Shit, goddammit.
I don't like how this threshing area doesn't update on the server.
I mean, all, like, spots are missed or what?
No, on the monitor, it's supposed to be, like, real-time threshing counter. But...
it'd probably be a nicer move just to put it in the... put it in the semi, but I have so much fun dumping into this new cart.
Thing looks sharp. Gotta use it.
That spout. That spout is awesome.
Yeah, it's amazing how much different it looks now that I've built the new pipe. It's like a totally... it looks so different. It's great. And that was a fun thing to build. That was really cool. Like, if you look at it, I have, like, the... like, on the top part, it's got, like, bolted on rubber inside the spout. And I just wish I could get the...
hydraulic animation.
Yeah, I should have, like, took that spout, that tips, I should have, like, moved that away when I was burning it so it's not black, you know. Whoops. I can still do it.
I think that's a great way to do it.
So I'm at 92%.
That was the funniest thing. You updated your Kinsey, so that means the old one's coming out? You're funny.
That was this. What was that? When I built the DB60, they're like, "Oh, so you're gonna..."
Yeah, that would have been a AEM admin that asked you for that.
Yep. Want to take my line?
Are you out?
I'm 100%.
Yeah, I'll come back and grab yours when I go. I'm gonna grab mine.
The cart driver thought it would be a convenient time to take a break.
Hey, he's still doing better than Trey falling asleep sitting in the middle of the field.
Where's our truck driver? Ah, sorry guys, I'm sleeping.
Yeah, an hour and a half later. When your girlfriend came on to play with the wood chipper, though, that was about the best night I think I've ever had.
Dude, that was great. Yeah, that was pretty funny.
Or the first night she found out you had a potty page. Shut up, you guys.
You guys did so not dirty. Help the situation. There's Jake. Oh, he's got a modding page. Lynn BJ modding. It's like, shut up.
Oh my god, I was so showing my friends.
There was a video of where I was like doing the map and I got the soybeans in a row.
Yeah.
And like, she was laughing her ass off at that because I'm like, oh, look at those soybeans in a row. She's like, she didn't understand. She's like, I don't get it. Like,
yeah. You're so rustic. Rustic? Did you just say rustic?
She's crazy.
I don't want to play this game. Just try it. And then she wouldn't give you the computer back. Joe, you go to your ditch.
Well,
that was fun. Bring the telehandler up with two logs. Joe, I need help pushing this in the ex-wife. That trailer looks nice, but it almost like you'd have to make the capacity higher than 10,000 unless we're actually going to chop wood to 8 meters long.
I want to do it realistic. Like, we had fun and everything, but I'd like to have like a kind of a more realistic operation.
Well, now that they've done all these updates, maybe actually cutting logs.
I have. Yeah, I haven't paid any attention to forestry for over a year.
But it always ends up where that last piece gets really small and you can't ever get it to grab anything.
Yeah. Maybe they came out with like some decent forestry excavators where you could just like stockpile it. And then you could have a guy on a crane that's just feeding the chipper and then a guy on the trucks.
I don't know if they've made a crane yet. That'd be nice. or
you know,
better.
We just stockpile it, and the guy on a crane just feeds the chipper.
Yeah, like in that old axeman that they used to have on Discovery Channel.
Mm-hmm. Or like you can like even refer to like Gold Rush, the wash plant. You're just stockpiling, you know,
pay dirt.
And then you got one guy that's just feeding the machine.
I'm a big Gold Rush fan.
Huh?
I'm a big Gold Rush fan.
I like it, but I mean, they're so retarded that... What I don't get is that they like, their gross revenue is so small compared to their, like how much they're spending. Like, if they had to purchase that equipment or they own that equipment, they wouldn't make shit. And you look at like, okay, you got like 10, 14 guys, you probably pay them $50,000 each. I don't know how they make any money.
They don't know. The guys that get paid, they get paid off what they make at the end of the year in gold. So if they flunk out and don't make shit, none of the workers do.
I know.
All the work.
The mechanics, I'm pretty sure, are wage.
Yeah. Tony Beats, though, he owns all that equipment because he's been gold mining for what, 20
years?
Yeah,
well, his overhead is so low because you're right, he owns it.
Yeah, like Parker and Todd, they rent all that shit.
Plus, they're paying royalties, they don't own the land, like, you know, they're not making any money. I mean, they're, like, making enough to keep doing it, but they're not making enough to, like, you know, you need a...
Survival.
You need to, like, in order to make, like, sustainable wealth doing that, you need to cut your overhead. The only way you do that is by not operating on debt, not loans, you know?
Have you saved this game lately?
This one?
Before you do, go back to your career save game and see how much it tells us for, bushels. Or what we... You said we started with, like, 5,000 of corn?
Yeah.
I think it's 8,000, isn't it?
No, I'm talking way before.
No, it was like, there is like 8, there's like 5,000 left.
I'll just say 6. We got 500 and something in the bin, like it won't be ordered.
It's like 546,000 right now.
And your cart's full.
Yeah, I can see that.
and I'm about full.
And I'm about full.
I would probably grab Joe.
I hope you got your protein shake, because you're going to need it.
Well, yeah, you got two big loads waiting for you.
I think we should have parked the trucks, like, parallel with the road. That way when he pulls out of the lane, so you just, like, parallel up with the...
Oh, we always park them like this in the center of the cut, though.
Yeah, well, that's not the center of the cut.
I know, but we didn't have a center cut out because we didn't have enough room.
Yeah.
So are you going left and I go right, or are you going right and I go left?
I'll go right. I'm not sure I'll make it there, but...
No, you'll probably have to stop and I'll probably have to stop.
You could probably, like... work your way back on the right and unload into the truck, you know?
I'm gonna be too close, I think. I'll let you take the one on the right, because that's the shorter pass, so you'll be less full by the time we get to the other side. Because we're both gonna have to sit.
Well, you might as well just take it and unload into the truck while he's unloading me, and then we can just both go.
Well, wait, no.
What
Mike's
I would do for that bin extension.
Yeah. What? Can you imagine if we had two of these with bin extensions?
Like, it'd be nice for corn, but I mean...
Mike would be slacking if he did. Mike would be really screwed if he went took a lunch break with that.
He'd need a bigger tractor.
Yeah, he needs a bigger tractor.
No, I need a truck, a full-time truck driver.
Yeah.
Yeah, where's Colby?
If we were running 16-row headers, we'd definitely need...
a full-time truck driver.
Yeah, we'd be pulling out...
Are you just going to jump in the truck there?
Yeah? Yeah, you can go get Jake. should be able to hit the truck from.
No. Didn't get far enough over. I should have. We're not even half done with 17 yet.
This is gonna be like 450,000.
Ready to go, Mike.
Okay. Yeah, like these are all the short rounds, yeah.
It gets really, really long passes there towards the pig barns.
I can't wait to do 18 again. 18 is such a nice field. Nice long rolls, pretty straight field. 18 is pretty nice.
Yeah.
Who the hell is 18?
The one south of here. One around the hog barn.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
The hog barn that we never use.
Yeah, 18, Joe, there's some goofy terrain. Not goofy, but if you run the draper headers too close to the ground, they hang up quite a bit.
That's with every field.
No, that's why you had that header adjust.
No, I know. I was just curious because I know that one day you were wanting to let us to let you know if we found anything.
Yeah, there's just times that it's easier to take it off auto and just hit shift J till it goes all the way up to like 0.5.
Yeah.
I always like it's a hook and headers that are combines and like headers at like a 45 degree angle. How do I fix this? Download cutter attachment. I actually like you can adjust your header height like in real life.
Yeah.
Too bad you can't make it tilt by mouse control. So like when we pull into a field and the fence post is there, you can lift the one side to get it over.
Lateral post.
You could do it with mouse control.
Yeah.
But you just have to. I mean, your keyboard functions are already like. Taken up
nope.
With the pipe, the spoke.
Like, I'm talking like we can tilt the right side of the header higher than the left side with
yeah, the
button.
The lateral
and the
tilt.
Yep.
Yeah.
That'd be cool.
Or the pipe. So, like, if I could understand, like, if fill planes worked in 15 in multiplayer, like, make the spout on the combine move with mouse control. So that way we could move it back and forth, like, to get the cart full. You want to make this two cuts or three sections to finish this?
Three. How much?
I'd say let's just go three because these rounds are going to be long. I'd say cut this one out and cut the middle of that out. Just do a full round the next day. Maybe. We gotta ask the boss if he's in charge. We're just minions.
Be nice if we had a truck driver. I think we're pulling in enough grain where they would actually be busy. Maybe not this close to the farm, but if we were like...
Yeah, but it also, if we're doing that, they could almost be tilling part of a different field and just come drive
through. I think next season, this upcoming season, we should lease 19.
19? I could go for that again.
And maybe the 19. Field's like 31, 32.
Why not 23? I've never done 23 before.
Yeah, pick that one up. Pick that one up and...
Because we've done 31, 32.
We can pick up 23, 19, and 29.
And I'd go 29.
Yeah.
29.
Pick up three more big fields.
29 would be fun to harvest.
Those are three new big fields that we'll definitely have to plow in. You know, we're going to have to rent a DN, broadcast some nutrients, and chisel plow that in. We could probably get away with disking. You know, I'll probably have the disc done by the time we finish harvest. So.
Could you DN it and spray it, or no?
You can DN and spray?
I didn't know, like, if you want to really get the nutrients high, can't we run?
You could put down, you could put, like, NPK and PK. You could put down all three and really boost it.
That's what I figured. Do NPK and then do N with the sprayer, since you can do liquid nitrogen with sprayers. You just use a shit ton of liquid to do it. But that's. We put liquid fertilizer on.
You can broadcast all three or whatever, do whatever you want. But I mean, if you were to like broadcast NPK and spray NPK, you wouldn't get any benefit of extra NPK. You know, you would just get the moisture.
No, I meant spray, or I meant DN NPK spray N. Because then you could do both at the same time in the field. One spraying, one spread.
Yeah, you can do multiple combinations.
Yeah, one it's spraying. Well, you can broadcast it.
Oh, another two. Another two trucks.
Yeah, I gave up trying to keep back. I'm just gonna take like 6,000 off our total when we're done with corn. There goes Mike and follow me. You're gonna make it all the way up here. Turn it out. Yeah, that's still getting me.
So is that truck number 4?
Yeah. So we're probably gonna have 6 or 7 trucks.
We're gonna have probably 10 trucks or so.
That's 500,000 just off this field.
Yeah. I was figuring maybe 450. We'll probably get like 550.
Joe gonna come to the other side of the car. Like if you, like when you use hood hider, that like the name would still show who's driving what.
Yeah, that'd be nice.
Like, cause if hood hider's off, I can't see the Joe above your combine. And I can't see Mike's team speed nickname on top of his cart. I couldn't remember if you used to be able to get the pipe pop out without switching between the combine and the head.
Yeah, it's IC control. Your right control, and then you hit the thing on the pipe.
Oh.
The handle of the joystick. I like corn.
Me too. Because there's just so many things in here that are real crap that you kind of get bored of doing.
Yep.
MacDon after a while. Remember that night we first MP'd, how long ago, when we were doing corn?
That was...
You first put drive control in and you were getting mad because I couldn't figure out how to run it. Yeah, think back how many months ago when we first MP'd.
That was before last December.
Yeah.
October, November.
And think how much butter we've caused the FS world since then.
Well, just think how shitty it got. I didn't do shit.
No. It's gotten bad ever since 11. I think that one kid. Giants is going to stop selling FS because of all the crap. Nobody releasing stuff. No. Giants is not going to quit releasing that game. If people in North America quit buying it, they'll quit releasing.
It's a European company.
Yeah.
They're trying to get into the American market, but it's totally dominated in Europe.
Well, because everybody uses European mods. You have to edit your own mod for it to be American.
Well, all the modders are, like, quality, you know... Everything is European. The American market is shit. If you go out, the best American mods are made by Brazilians or Italians, you know. Well, I just recently got good. But the people that have been around, like the.
Yeah, Raphael. Screw European stuff. I want American.
You know, but like all the good mods were not made by American. I mean, there's guys like Kramer J, like, that guy was really good, like, he could model, like, his PJ trailers are nice.
You know what would look great on that 1500?
Delta track. What?
A Delta track.
A Delta track?
A 550 Versatile.
Oh, yeah. I would agree. But come on, let's be real here.
Raphael will probably start three more projects before
he's gonna get bored and move on to something else. Right when it's 70%.
That J&M 1500 track, I wish he would have completed that.
Yeah, I would be using that over the Kinsey.
That thing is pretty good. Joe's gonna run out for me.
My beacons are gonna come on.
I'm a whole 25% below you. Yeah, beacons come on at 80, right when it turns yellow. Mike had to turn and follow me off so Joe didn't lose money. I'm just waiting
that
for
that thing burns through the cache.
It almost burns too much.
That's why I never use it. It's like 2,500 an hour, I think. It's the same as the default course play until I drop it down. But now we never use it because we just do MPs.
We have enough people, yeah. But like you said, you need a truck driver. Do you really trust anybody else with all your stuff?
No.
I mean, if Josh ever came and played.
Who?
Yeah, well...
That's a big hill here. You know, that's perfect timing, Mike, because by the time you get done with him, I'll be about full, and then you'll have to dump again.
Yeah.
Mateus comes on quite a bit, so I mean...
Yeah, but I think right about now is like 3 o'clock in the morning for him over there. Him at like 9 o'clock, but our time is like midnight.
Yeah. The only time we need a dedicated truck driver is if we're doing corn like we are, just to keep the whole system going.
Cool.
I saw that.
Oh my god.
Did you take out a K-Dub?
That cruise is really screwing me up. Because it used to be you could have the cruise on, hit reverse, and it wouldn't go back. But now, better hope you're going the right direction. Do you imagine picking up bales with this cruise control? Well, flying into the bale at like 16, hit reverse, hopefully you lock it quick enough. I'd almost think about like payloaders, like if you had a smaller payloader like the New Holland or something, or a little bit smaller, get like the double bale fork for the round bales, that'd be fun.
Bales are fun to do, except when you get them all stacked next to one another, then the game kind of gets all funky.
I wish there was a way to fix the collision that happened when you use that thing.
Yeah. Well, that didn't take long to fill up that 1,500 bushel cart.
I wasn't right empty, though. I didn't quite,
He's getting pushed down the hill by the cart.
That tractor up that hill's like, you want me to do what?
And then going down the hill, it's looking behind it. Quit pushing me!
But that was cool watching you guys unload. You just sit back and watch it. This game is like pretty relaxing. Especially in the cab of the combine, it's nice and quiet.
I don't even have my sounds turned on. I should probably go. I'd always turn my sound off because sitting in the combine, it was like, now that silent sound in here is back, it's probably better. Mixer. Go to 30, try that. Oh, yeah, it's a lot quieter in cab. I think I'm going to stay in cab.
Yeah, if you pan out, it's pretty loud.
Yeah, I'm just trying to get how heavy I want to get. I hear dogs. I'm so glad the GPS sounds are updated.
Everyone's asking for them.
Turn on my camera even though I can see through it. I wonder if there's a way to go in and like make the back of that not do it, because it never did it in 09 so, or 13, so I wonder if you have to go back and steal something from the Lua. Perfect time to switch close to my pipe camera, I see Mike flying across the field.
So do you lag any less with your new computer, or, Mike?
Oh, it runs fine.
That's good.
Like I said, I don't get huge numbers on frames, anywhere from 30 to 40, but it looks 10 times better than my old one.
Yeah.
And it hasn't been lagging bad at all. Like, the map doesn't, maps don't lag anymore. It's just the server lag every once in a while.
That's the funniest thing. I want a good computer that can run FS and a bunch of mods and a bunch of maps, but I don't want to spend any money. Well, you're not going to have a good computer then.
No. I spent almost $2,000 on this thing.
Jesus. You could build a desktop for that. Less than that.
His is a laptop,
yeah.
I can upgrade this. I like it's a desktop, though. It's one of those Alienware.
Yeah, that's good.
So.
I thought about going through Newegg and building a new one, but looking at the price.
I'm going to use it as part of a farm write-off as a home office.
I want like an 8 gigabyte video card.
I think that's what this one is. Like it's not NVIDIA, it's the AMD equivalent to, I think it would be just below a 970, I think they said.
Yeah, I think I'm going to go with what Joe's got for a graphics card, the better one.
And everybody said that, like, read reviews, and they say these AMD run really loud, like the fans on them, but I haven't had an issue. Like, they say it runs hot, and the fans are obnoxious, but it runs this game, barely makes it sweat. Especially on this map.
I tried to optimize it enough where you get as much detail as possible, but you don't load up. It doesn't bog up your RAM.
No. Yeah, like it comes with some pretty good optimization software, like the built-in stuff. So, like I've got everything. I got the video card detail on high. The games loaded right up on high, and I'm impressed with it. Like you saw those pictures I posted with the John Deere equipment, it looks damn near real.
Yeah.
People, how do you get your game to look so real? Better computer.
I post the specs on all my videos and people still ask me what computer I have.
Yeah.
Read the description, it saves lives. Like, I can post a link to all my mods there, they won't even know it.
I guarantee you have kids looking at your description for the next month.
You never know. Keep your eyes open.
Oh, kids get pissed if they ask for a mod and I send them, like, my whole screenshots folder in a Dropbox mod. These are just screenshots. Enjoy. You're what makes this community bad. No, I'm what brings this community entertainment. Get it right.
I always like it's the people that are like the actual problem that are like, we're gonna save it. With what? Lego build? Hack job? No.
John Deere reskins.
Let me grab my rattle can.
I'm going to reskin the John Deere back into a case and be like, look what I made. Looks pretty good, doesn't it?
What's
like
that?
It looks like a Casey Colo Tiger.
No, it's a DMI Ripper. No,
it's a 7200 chisel plow. No.
Let me reskin the 2410 into a Krauss 5635. Why do you want to do Krauss? I was thinking about why do you really want to do Krauss? Because Joe Lindbergh did it. And I want to be like him.
Some guy like slapped a 5635.
Yeah, Logan Johns.
On the on the on the in-game horse. I'm like, that's not even close.
Yeah.
Some kid posted a picture, goes, look at my croon cows, 4635, or 5635, and I posted a picture of Joe, they go, look at the one in my game, I win.
I just want to get that John Deere disc in game, because that thing's going to make that Kraus obsolete.
Yeah. Somebody reskins the 2410 into a 5635, and somebody makes the Great Plains soil finisher. You're not trying to be like Joe Lindbergh there.
Makes a Cat Challenger.
Oh, shit.
Perimeter! Right? No?
No, we got two passes. You can do it if you want us to. We'll just be on the wrong side to start perimeter. We're not doing a very good job of getting everything.
I think we're doing a good job.
Yeah.
When you got
load 5,
load 5 or load 6?
No, I'm not doing it. I'm taking one in all the card dumps.
Oh. You're close enough.
So we're at 5 trucks, so we figure we had 5 or 6 more to go.
At least. We got the biggest part.
A small 14 and 24 down there.
Look at 19 or 29. Those side hills. Can you imagine trying to combine that north and south? We'd have to have hill masters.
You'd probably do like seven. You would go, I don't know. You would do like contour.
No, you go east west. Wouldn't want contour. You ever seen those Hillmaster fishing combines that adjust to do side hills?
Yeah, that's ridiculous.
I'd probably be shitting a brick while driving along that hill.
They have a couple, it's down, southwest Wisconsin. It's kind of hilly, so you see guys like, from that.
I don't get scared going 180 on a motorcycle down the interstate, but go on. Kind of sitting like that in a combine or a tractor. That's good.
Yeah.
I hate like mowing ditches and breaking a ditch when you're sitting on the side of it. Ugh, I would not be very good at doing that. Like the guys that mow the interstate off-ramp ditches, are just like straight up signs. You, sir, have bigger gonads than I do.
Doesn't take much.
Load six going in.
Don't worry, we'll fill up your cart.
You might have to back to the back side of that cart for one.
Nah, we'll get it 2/3 the way full.
Oh, there's something up there.